Anders Breivik, who killed 77 people in Norway's worst peacetime atrocity. Dylan Roof, who shot dead 9 black churchgoers in South Carolina. And Luca Traini, who wounded 6 African migrants in Italy. Right-wing extremists in different parts of the world, supported by the suspect in the Christchurch slaughter, in a manifesto filled with far-right rants, raising fears of further attacks among a loose global network of white supremacists.
The manifesto can be read almost as a call to action. It really says that it's trying to further polarize, but also to create fear and anger in our societies and to...
Anders Breivik, who killed 77 people in Norway's worst peacetime atrocity. Dylan Roof, who shot dead 9 black churchgoers in South Carolina. And Luca Traini, who wounded 6 African migrants in Italy. Right-wing extremists in different parts of the world, supported by the suspect in the Christchurch slaughter, in a manifesto filled with far-right rants, raising fears of further attacks among a loose global network of white supremacists.
The manifesto can be read almost as a call to action. It really says that it's trying to further polarize, but also to create fear and anger in our societies and to incite violence and this war that the perpetrator wants to spark.
New Zealand is not known as a hotbed of far-right extremism, but scores of groups are thought to exist, linking up online with others around the world.
They know exactly what's happening in the UK with Tommy Robinson and perhaps the fact that he's been banned from Facebook, or what's happening in the US and the alt-right.
Analysts say divisive language by populist politicians is helping to fuel far-right extremism. This Australian lawmaker blamed the New Zealand shooting on Muslim immigration. While Donald Trump came under fire 2 years ago for being slow to denounce a white supremacist rally in Charlottesville, Virginia.
There's a strong view out there that people like President Trump are fueling this poisonous right wing. And these acts are happening as a result of that rubber stamping by such senior officials. So I'm afraid, put it bluntly, some people feel that President Trump has blood on his hands.
The president took to Twitter to condemn the Christchurch killings. My